this is one of them. Trish and I, as my collection manager and colleague, just published on this one. We were looking at these rod-shaped organisms.
Yeah, you can get even closer.
Yeah, you're short. You get to go up front. You can see tracks here that are pretty clear. And all of this was covered by a microbial mat. Let's see. Yeah. You can see where the mat's wrinkled right in here. What we did was we mapped this whole slab. The first person that published on these said that these were burrows. But if you look at them, you can see there's a great deal of alignment. And they tend to fall into two groups. The ones that are aligned that way, and then these that are kind of perpendicular to it. So the hypothesis was that these are knocked down by current, and these are rolling with the current. When we mapped all of them and measured the orientation, we found that they really were. So that's one of our recent publications.
Where Trish and I. Where is this collected
from? Fundamentalist Church in near Oakboro.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a running joke. Every time they do a they expand a fundamentalist church, they find some more.
You said it was Precambrian?
That's Precambrian, yeah. It's okay. Late Proterozoic.
That's
you might be
amazing.
More familiar with the term Ediacaran.
Yep.
The Ediacarans? Yeah. So North Carolina's got some Ediacarans, and there's been a recent bunch of findings, and Trish and I have been publishing on those. These are furnaces, and it'd probably be better if you didn't touch them. So we can do high temperature, high pressure experiments up to about 900 degrees centigrade and 2 kilobars. Unfortunately, we had, I'm not spanking it, I'm making sure it's not hot. One of them starting to fail a bit, so I don't know what's wrong with these bombs. And then, of course, you're all familiar with the way the Chinese are putting screws to us with rare earth elements. Well, back in the early part of the 20th century, late 19th century, North Carolina was a major producer of monazite, which contains a lot of rare earths. And they were mostly sands, you know, stuff weathering out of the Appalachians and collecting down in the western Piedmont. So we've got samples from the old monazite mines in our collection. And we're taking another look at them. They contain a lot of thorium, which is what's radioactive, but the rare earths are what's of interest as a strategic mineral.